Hello, it's 2025, and one thing we know for sure is that over the last 18 months, AI has taken the world by storm. But how do you actually use AI with an actual practical drone data project? We'll have a look in this video. So in this video, what we're going to do is we're going to look at an example data set captured using drones. This is essentially a shopping mall that was captured using drones. And one of the things we'll find is that actually this shopping mall has been suffering from all sorts of water ponding issues. So once I bring up the data set, you'll notice that there's all sorts of issues on the roof and facades of this building. And we want to actually use AI to help us quantify the amount of water ponds on this particular building and also to find all of them without having to go through every single image. So let's have a look at what the workflow looks like. So here's the shopping mall that I was talking about earlier. As you can probably tell, there's been all sorts of water ponding issues with this particular shopping mall. And you can see it's quite evident all these different puddles of water on the roof that are accumulating. And not just the roof, but also the facades and all the sort of ground level has sort of had similar issues. So what we're going to do is we're going to use AI in this project for us to find all of these different ponding water, and then also to be able to quantify how many of these particular puddles there are. Now, for AI to work, it doesn't really have to be water ponds. It could work on cracks, it can work on other types of issues. But in this particular data set, we're going to focus on that because that was the issue with this particular building. In terms of how this building was captured using drones and what kind of flight paths were used and how the data was brought in and merged together, all of that is actually covered in our previous video. So if you want to get some context to this particular project, we're going to link that video in the top right corner now. And without further ado, let's get into the AI workflow. Right. So what we see in front of us is we've got all these different images, right? So we've got, I don't know, like 421 images. And we don't necessarily want to go through every single image and look at, where are all of these different sort of water ponding issues. I mean, of course, we can do that, but it's such a laborious task. And it doesn't really add a lot of value to the end client, right? Because the end client, the building owner, really wants to know what is the problem with their building. And, if you spend more time sort of quantifying and suggesting repairs or suggesting what they should be doing, that's a valuable resource, valuable use of time, as opposed to sort of spending time finding all these issues. So the key question is, how do we use AI to find all these issues? Well, we're going to be using Hammer Missions for this particular task. So if you don't have an account with Hammer Missions, you can always essentially go to hammermissions.com and you can set up your account over there. So this platform will essentially you help us to detect all of the different issues. So what we're going to do, going back to our project, is we're going to essentially prompt the AI what sort of issues we're looking for. So if I go to any one of these images, just going to go to like a random image over here. I'm actually going to pick a better example because that one doesn't have a very clear water pond. Okay. So I'm going to click on the image here and I'm going to bring it up. So this over here is a drone image, and that is a 3D model that's been produced using the drone images. And so what I'm going to do is I'm going to mark up these water ponds using my markup tool. And that's how I'm going to communicate with the AI what I'm looking for. To do that, I'm going to use the polygon tool over here. I'm going to select that, and then I'm going to hold down the shift key. I'm going to start drawing a boundary along this particular polygon so that I can mark it in its entirety. Once I've finished, I can just double click to finish the polygon, and then I can give it a tag. So I've already got a tag in place, but if I didn't have one, I could just type in water pond, and it would not let me create water pond, but it'll let me create a new tag water pond. So I'm not going to do that because I've already got a tag here. So I'm just going to tag it as water pond. Okay. And that basically gets marked up on that image and stays on that image. Now I need to do the same thing for other water ponds in this image because I need to obviously tell my AI what I'm looking for. And if I don't do that effectively, it doesn't really know what it's looking for, right? So you need to be able to communicate in its language what you are looking for. And so I'm just going to go around marking all of these different water ponds. Now, it might seem like a laborious activity, but we really realistically don't need to do this for more than 5 to 10 images in our data set. That's sort of like the starting point. But towards the end of the video, I will also give you a framework that you can use to actually build up AI data sets in a more scalable way so that you can do this process in a more scalable fashion. And you can basically do that for multiple projects so that, you know, if you're capturing more than one shopping mall, you can essentially build up a process that you can use over and over again to be able to give you that scalability that you might need. So I'm just going to go ahead and continue marking the water ponds. I'm being very rough in my sort of marking here. Ideally, you want to be as precise as possible. You want to also ensure that you're covering all of the all of these water ponds, or if you're marking something else, some other deficiency like a crack, you want to make sure that you're marking all of the different instances in an image and you're not leaving any of them. So if you pick an image, you got to pick an image which has enough examples of that particular type of issue, such as a water pond, and you want to mark them up properly. Okay, so you've got the markup done in this image. And what I've also done to save time is that I've actually marked up some other images before this video. So I'm just going to cycle through some of those. So for example, I marked these two up, and admittedly, I should have marked up these as well, just so that everything in the image is covered. So I've marked up more of these water ponds here too. And this one was the one that we just did. Looks very familiar. And yeah, here's more examples. I should have marked up these two, admittedly, but it doesn't really matter. If you have 90% coverage, that should do it. So, and yeah, you've got all of these marked up. Okay, I did do a good job on this one. Well done to me on that image. And then you've got all these other sort of water ponds that you want to go out there and mark. Now, one of the other things you want to do is you also want to try and find, if you're going to mark up 5 to 10 images, you want to try and find 5 and 10 images that look slightly different. So for example, here, the drone's taken images with a top down point of view, looking straight down. And so you want to be able to identify some of those images as well in the data set that look slightly different so that, you know, you can tell your AI, hey, I want to find these issues too, taken from this angle. Don't just focus on a particular type of angle. So, but AI is pretty good. It can understand once you've marked up what you're looking for. So I've done sort of 11 images and I think I'm done here. I'm like, okay, I'm going to sort of, you know, delegate this to the AI, please. And I don't want to really go out there and do all of the work myself. So what I'll do is I'll go into the AI function here in Hammer Missions. And I will request to create a new AI model. So let's call this water pond demo, something like that. And in my description, I could say trained using 11 images in 2025. Okay, you can give it another description if you want. You can basically use it to track changes. And yeah, you just hit the create button over here. Now, to save time, I've already set up an AI model. This typically takes about an hour to create. So, you know, you can go out there, make yourself a cup of coffee or tea, whatever your preference might be, and to come back. And what you'll find is in your data sets, in your AI models, you should find an AI model for water ponds. So, for example, we've got water ponds example here, and also one for ponding water. So actually, ponding water is the one that I'm going to use here because I recall that was the one that I trained to be able to use on this data set. And so all I have to do now is I'm going to basically press use. And once I do that, Hammer's AI utility will actually go out there and start looking for all of the different examples of ponding water, and it will mark up all of the images that have similar deficiencies and similar issue. And one thing that you need to bear in mind is that this process doesn't just work for ponding water. It works for cracks, it works for spalls, it works for any kind of deficiency you can think of that has some form of a pattern that you want the AI to be looking for. So we're going to let AI do that, and whilst it does that, we're going to explore some other functions which are going to be useful for quantification and reporting later on. So one of the issues you might have come across is even though, let's imagine the AI has gone out there and marked up all of the images, then the question becomes, well, some of these images are duplicates, right? Because the drone has flown over the sort of over the building multiple times. And so one of the things you want to do is you want to essentially take all of these annotations you've made, and you want them to really sort of appear on the model, because the model is a 3D representation of the building, and it's probably the best source of truth with respect to all of the different issues. So what you can do in Hammer is you can essentially click on this tool over here, 3D annotations, and then you choose the display 3D annotations option. You click that, and what Hammer Missions will do is that it will go out there and see all of the different deficiencies, all of the different ponding water examples you found that you've already found, and it will label them in 3D. So if you see, you'll find that all of the ponding water that we had essentially marked up in 2D have now been marked up in 3D. Isn't that neat? And what it would also do is it would actually group some of these annotations for you. So it might be that actually number 44, which is an image that we looked at. So if I click on this point, I can bring up some of the images that show that. So for example, some of these annotations are showing up multiple times. So that's obvious because you've got multiple images that can see that particular point. And so if you sometimes get multiple annotations, multiple issues being labeled in your images, Hammer will even group them together. So over here, it's grouped 44, 55, and 62 into group number 44. And that sort of tells you that's only one annotation as opposed to three annotations. It's done the sort of same thing for some of the other annotations. And that just allows you to quickly see what is the total count of all the annotations. Obviously, when we export this into a report, it will allow us to see the total number of all the different water ponds. But what I'm going to do now is I'm going to pause, I'm going to wait for the AI to finish, and then we're going to come back looking at the data set with respect to all of the images marked up, and then we'll finally have a look at the report. So we'll see you in a bit. Okay, we're back now after a cup of tea, and AI in the meantime has been churning away looking at all of the images. So what you'll notice is that we are very much in the same project as we were looking before. We've just basically refreshed our projects after receiving an email that we're done with the AI annotations. And what you'll see is that we've got 421 images, which is the same number as before. But now 389 images have been annotated, and I'm pretty sure we only annotated roughly 10, maybe 11 images of the data set. So what's happened here is that AI has actually gone out there and it's marked up all of the different ponding water issues. So if I now look at all of these different images, if I, for example, click on that image, you will notice that you have the AI water pond that has been marked up on all of these images. And you've also got an AI water pond here, an AI water pond there, AI water pond here. And you'll also notice that actually the way AI is marking up these images is basically as dotted sort of boundary. And that's because we want it to be very clear that actually this is AI doing the annotation and not a human. So if I was to do an annotation, for example, if I do one here, you'll notice the solid line. Whereas if an AI was to do the annotation, it would be a dotted line. And that's really important because we want to be able to always distinguish who did this work. Was this work done by a human or was it done by AI? Because I think we're still in this sort of initial innings of AI. We really want to make sure that all the work that gets done by AI is actually checked, and we are able to sort of ensure that when it comes to critical things like repairs for buildings, everything has been double and triple checked. But at the same time, that doesn't mean we can't leverage AI to actually do all of the markups. So you see, we've got an issue there that's been marked up, an issue that's been marked up here. And if I now go into some of the data sets here, okay, before we go and do that, this image is a good example. So AI will find all the things we're looking for, but every now and then it will mess up. So, for example, here it's found this particular pipe, and that's obviously not a water pond. So, what's that all about? Now, you will get these sort of sort of issues with AI every now and then. But if you click on that, you will see that actually the confidence that the AI assigns to this particular annotation is really low. It's 55%. So it's sort of like saying it's a 50% chance that it's a water pond or not. And so what we can do is we can actually filter out those annotations that are less than a certain threshold for us. So if I go and change this, we will see that it would actually get rid of those. If I look at this image and bring up the confidence threshold, I only want to see things in this image that are over 91%, and it will get rid of that for me. So you can always use different tools at your disposal to filter and ensure that you're looking at the right things. And that's where we are with AI today. So let's look at these sort of bigger examples. Well, this one was done by us, so that makes sense. That came out fine. But here, AI has actually gone out there and found these two. And what's interesting here, if we look at the example, we had marked up these two, right? But we hadn't marked up that or that. And what AI has done in the image is it's gone out there and found an extra one over here, right? And so all of these images have now been essentially labeled, and AI has gone out there and marked up all of these different issues. And so we find that to be the case throughout the data set. I'm cherry picking here to be able to bring up different issues. So, for example, here it's got it wrong again. Now, that is an actual car as opposed to a water pond. So, it's got some things that aren't exactly right. And so, when it comes to some of those issues, what you have to remember is that this AI has only seen 10 images of a particular deficiency of a particular issue. And so, it's going to be a bit like, a young sort of trainee person who doesn't really understand exactly what they're doing yet. But the goal is that if you do this enough number of times, AI gets really, really good and it's able to actually improve in its accuracy. Again, over here, it's sort of gone out there and found most of those. It missed some of these. So that's not very good. But we have to remember that this was an example with just 10 images. Now, before we finish the video, I will give you a technique on how you improve this. So over here, it's done a pretty good job. It's found all of the different sort of water ponds. It's probably arguably it's missed this small one, but is that really a water pond? Maybe not. Maybe not. That's why that one's debatable. So yeah, and then you look at sort of you cherry pick and you look at the images and you see whether AI has done a good job of finding these deficiencies or not. You go around and if you're quite confident that it's actually done a good job, then we move into the phase where we've got all these markup done. And the key question is, well, how do we now quantify how many water ponds there are? And how do we actually get all of that quantification into a report so that we can start thinking about the repairs and the maintenance? So if you want to learn a little bit more about that, you will have to wait for our next video. And so I'm going to stop here and ask you to subscribe to our channel so that you can stay tuned for our next video where we're going to go through how do you actually quantify how many water ponds there are on the roof and how do you get all of that exported into a report. And the last thing I want to say here is that there is a process here that you can follow with multiple different projects where you can train your AI again and again over time. So, for example, that water pond that we trained, the ponding water model that we trained, we can actually improve it. And so, again, how do we do that is something we're going to cover in another video. I'm going to thank you so much for watching, and we hope to see you in the next video for Knowledge Hub.